Ladies and gentlemen, today I'm here at the Victoria Falls Safari Lodge. Today we are having the vulture feeding. We are visiting the place where they do conservation of vultures. It is called the Vulture Restaurant. It's like vultures are vulnerable. They are facing persecution when they go out there in the wild. Some people poison them. Some people do what kind of things. So they kill them. So by feeding them or by giving them meat here at the Safari Lodge, they are trying by all means to draw them away from where they can be killed or from where they can be persecuted. So please join me and enjoy the vulture feeding.
Marabou stock. Also another fascinating bird, that one, we'll talk much about the marabou stock later. Let me quickly get back to the reasons why we are feeding these vultures. Studies have been done to ascertain the reason why the vulture population has been dropping year in, year out. After those studies, a lot of results were pointing at us human beings. How then do we get involved? Let's look into the farming side. Most of the farmers in our region here are those type of farmers who practice subsistence farming, and there is no much of crop production in this region. So most of their wealth lies in the number of livestock they own. So the farmer wakes up in the morning checking on his livestock, only to find out that one or two beasts have been killed by predators. That would be a great loss to that farmer. So what they think of is to eliminate or to do away with those predators once and for all, so that there won't be any such losses in the future. That's when they come up with ideas such as putting poison on the leftover carcass, hoping that if those predators come to finish their kill, they feed on poison, beat and all die. But forgetting that those predators are also very, very sensitive animals. Whenever they sense human movement, especially in the early hours of the morning, they quickly move back into the wild where they belong. And when it's daylight, what comes first is a vulture. As you can see right now in front of us, ladies and gentlemen, these are gregarious birds. They always feed in large groups. So imagine if I had put poisoned meat here, how many vultures I would have killed in just 5 to 10 minutes. It means this whole flock which came here today can disappear on just one carcass. But remember, vultures do not multiply all that fast. A single vulture lays a single egg every year, which takes 54 to 56 days to hatch. Once it's hatched, a vulture doesn't leave the mother's nest until it's a sub-adult, which will take another 4 to 5 months. So for us to come up with a flock that came here today, it can take 5 even to 7 years. And imagine that all the birds which came here were all females, having babies back in the nest. That would also mean the number of babies who they've lost. But if the mothers die here on the feeding site, it means the babies also die in the nest. That is of starvation. But if the poison isn't strong enough, allowing these vultures to fly back to their young ones, they'll be also carrying warm poison stuff, which they will regurgitate to their young ones, which will die in the nest, and the mothers later on die. All that affected the vulture population, but still on those farmers, some of those farmers do have access to drugs. Whenever they have any sick animal, let's say it's a cow, they take their drug, inject the drug to their cow. If that cow doesn't recover, ending up dying, and the farmer doesn't bury it or burn it, and the vultures come feed on the carcass, they sometimes die because of those drugs. There are also drugs which don't kill vultures on the feeding site. But once they consume such carcasses, they sometimes get disturbed genetically, whereby in their future, they'll start laying eggs without stronger shells. And those eggs, they always crack or they break before they are hatched. That affects the vulture population as well. Let's look into the poaching side. Poachers are also other big culprits. Whenever they come in our national park areas or our private game reserves, they always sneak during the night using moonlight just to avoid game rangers. But if it's daylight and they happen to come across a big elephant with big tusks, they shoot it. By the time they're waiting on extracting the tusks, it's better have spotted them. They start soaring around, some landing on the nearby trees, waiting for their turn to do what they know best, cleaning the world. That would be feeding on carcasses. But if there is a national park game ranger nearby, surely goes there to check what the birds have seen, only to find poachers at work, who then get shot. But in such incidents, there are sometimes survivors. Those are the same people who risk their lives coming back in our national park areas, no matter even if we eliminate their colleagues. But those people have been asking, who has been spying on us? We came during the night, nobody noticed us, we tried to hide all our tracks, but all of a sudden, we've been attacked, only to realize that vultures are their biggest enemy. Whenever these birds locate any poached animal in the wild, they always alert game rangers. So after extracting the tusks, some of those poachers, they sometimes poison the whole elephant carcass, hoping that all the vultures in the region come.
Oh, that was a very informative piece of information from the guide there, talking about the vultures and conservation of vultures, which is very important. So yeah, thank you.